is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 28, 1975, in New Delhi, India.
Sri Vishava Uvacha Narayana Deha Deha Bhajana Niloki Kastan Kaman Arahadivi Bhujangaji Tapu Dibbang Putrakadina Satyam Suddhet Jasmad Brahma Sokam to Ananda. This is 5th chapter of the 5th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is a last contribution of Vyasadeva. Srimad Bhagavatam Nigama Kalpataru Galitam Phalamidam. In the beginning, introduction of Srimad Bhagavatam, Vyasadeva giving the information that this Srimad Bhagavatam is the Nigama Kalpataru Galitam Phalamidam. Nigama means Veda. So, compare the Vedas as a tree where you can get many fruits. So this Srimad Bhagavatam is described as Nigama Kalpataru Galitam Phalam. Kalpataru means desire tree. Desire tree, you can get any kind of fruit from that tree. In the material world, there are many different types of trees, fruits and flowers. But you can get one type of fruit or one type of flower from a particular type of tree. But there is another tree that is in the spiritual world, that is called desire tree. Whatever you want from that tree, you can get. Kalpataru. The spiritual world, description of the spiritual world is there in the Brahma Samhita. Chintamani prakara sadmasu kalpa brikha. There the trees are kalpa brikha. Nigama kalpataru. Kalpataru or kalpavrikha, the same thing. So, Vedas means knowledge. So from the Vedas, you can get all kinds of knowledge, both material and spiritual. Therefore it is called Veda, knowledge. So, in that tree of knowledge, the ripened fruit is Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is written by Vyasadeva after writing 4 Vedas and the 18 Puranas, the 108 Upanishads, Vedanta Sutra, and Mahabharata, in which Bhagavad Gita is set up. So, after compiling all these Vedic literatures, Vyasadeva was not satisfied. Then his spiritual master advised him to describe the activities of the Supreme Personality of God. That is Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavat, Bhagavan, the word Bhagavat, and Bhagavat is also in relationship with Bhagavat, or Bhagavan. So, every sloka of Srimad Bhagavatam is full of spiritual information. If we take advantage of this great Vedic literature, then we become fully aware of Bhagavan and the devotees of Bhagavan. Therefore it is named Bhagavatam. But this Bhagavatam has to be studied from the very beginning and take the lessons from live Bhagavatam. There are two kinds of Bhagavatam. One is Grantha Bhagavatam and the other is the Person Bhagavatam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised that if you want to understand Bhagavatam, then you must approach a person whose life is Bhagavatam. He said, Bhagavat Parobhya Bhagavatasthane. That if we learn, listen, Srimad Bhagavatam from the person Bhagavatam, then it is very easy to understand the spiritual knowledge given in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, here, Rishabhdev was the father of Maharaj Bharat, under whose name this land is called Bharatvarsha. Bharatvarsha is derived from the name of Maharaj Bharat. So his father, Rishabhdev, he is accepted as incarnation of Krishna. So he is giving instruction to his sons before retirement. In our Vedic culture, there is compulsory retirement. There is compulsory retirement. That is Vedic civilization. Varnasamtham. What is going on, as we are going on in the name of Hindus, but Hindu is not mentioned in the Vedic literature. In the Vedic literature, the principles or the institute followed by the inhabitants of Bharatvarsha is called Varnasram Dharma. That is real occupation. Varnasrama Charvata Purushena Parapraman Vishnu Aradhate Pumishang Nannat Tattosakara. Whole Vedic civilization means realize God. That is Vedic civilization. Vishnu Aradhate. We are part and parcel of Vishnu, or the Supreme Lord, as it is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Mamai vāṁsa jīva bhūta. Jīva bhūta. These living entities, not only human beings, but everyone, sarva-jonīṣu kaunteya, in every form of life, the living entities are covered with the material dress. So, Bhagavad Dharma or spiritual life can be understood when one has understood his identification, what he is. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita, the first lesson given by Krishna to Arjuna is to bring him to the spiritual platform. When Arjuna was lamenting on the body of his relatives on the other side, he was too much affected in the bodily conception of life. How I shall fight with the other side? They are all my brothers, nephews, my teacher, my grandfather, and who has fought with such enemies in the history? Everyone fights, there is fighting, but not fighting with own men, even at the present moment, although there is sometimes civil war. So Arjuna was too much affected by the bodily conception of life. That is the disease of this material world. We are thinking in terms of this body. But the Shastra says, yajyasyātma buddhi kunape iti dhātuke sadhik kalatra desu bhova ijyadhi jatīrtha buddhi salilena karhichi janesu avigneshu saiva gokhar. The bodily conception of life is animal life. If I think that I am this body, I am Indian, and you think that you are this body, you are American or Englishman, in so many ways we are designated. So long we think in these terms of knowledge that I am this body, jasyātma buddhi kunape iti dhātuke. This is a bag of three elements, kapha, pitta, vayu. Or if you don't understand kapha, pitta, vayu, we can understand that this body is made of flesh, bone, mucus. What we'll find if we dissect this body, we'll find flesh, blood, bone, urine, stool, so many things, these material things. But if we think that I have this body, composition of blood, flesh, bone, and urine and stool, is that very good intelligence? No. Therefore, Shastra says, anyone who is thinking this body, combination of these elements, combined together, it is called tridhātuke. Saiva gokhara. Such person is no better than the cows and the asses. Because I am not combination of this blood, bone, flesh, and urine and stool. I am not this combination. Aham brahmasmi. I am spirit soul. This is really realization, knowledge. So unless one comes to that platform, that I am beyond this blood, flesh, bone, urine, stool. Aparayam itastu vidvimi prakritim para. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. That these material elements, earth, water, air, fire, sky, mind, intelligence, ego, these are eight separated energy of the Supreme Lord. And the Lord says, aparāyam, these elements are inferior energy, itastu vidhime prakritim para. Beyond this, you try to understand there is another nature, prakriti. What is that another nature? Jīva-bhūta mahābhāho jayidam dhājate jagat. That is jīva-bhūta. So mamaivāṁsa jīva-bhūta. These living entities, Krishna says, they are my part and parcel. So we are now covered with these material energies, although I am spiritual energy. This is our position. So, this human form of life is a chance to understand that I am not this body, I am spiritual energy, I am Brahmasmi. This chance is given to the human form of life, not to the cats and dogs. So, the same principle is explained throughout all the Vedic literature in different ways, just to understand one's identity, that he is not this matter, he is spirit soul. And when you understand, then the next stage will be, then what is my duty? Because at the present moment, we are acting on the bodily concept of life. How this body shall be kept in comfort, how the bodily relationship, wife, children, family, community, society, nation, they're all expanded bodily concept of life. So, in any conception of this material world, if we live, then we are living like cats and dogs. You are not living as human beings. Otherwise, where is the difference? When we see on the street two dogs are fighting, one dog is thinking, this neighborhood is my jurisdiction, and why you have come from other jurisdiction in this neighborhood? They fight. It's the bodily concept of life. Or he's thinking, this neighborhood belongs to me. Why you have come from other neighborhood here? I say sometimes to my student, this is immigration department. One dog is barking on other dog, why you have come here? With this dog conception of life. The spiritual conception of life is that everything belongs to God. That is the fact. Isavasam midam sarvam. Everything belongs to God. The land, water, the sky. It is said, bhumirapa analo vayu. This is expansion of the energy of God. So what is the use claiming God's property as my property? That is mistake. This body is also God's property. Everything God's property. Because Krishna says, Bhumi rāpa nalo vāyu khaṅgamano buddhi deva. This microphone, what it is? It is made of some earthly metal, wood. But the material belongs to God. I may have taken advantage of taking this material and manufacture something, that does not mean it is mine. If a carpenter makes a good furniture and the wood is supplied by somebody else, and the carpenter is paid his wages, then when the nice furniture is made, to whom it will belong? To the carpenter or to the person who has supplied the ingredients? It is very common sense question. So, actually nothing belongs to us. We also do not belong independently. We are not independent. Krishna says, jiva bhuta, mamaivamsa. We are part and parcel of Krishna. Just like this finger is part and parcel of my body. So the finger has no separate existence. If this finger is cut off from my hand and it has a separate existence, it will fall down on the street. It has no value. Others are trampling down. Still nobody cares for it. Although it is the same finger, but cut off from this body. But so long this small finger is attached to this body, it has value. If there is some disease or pain, I can spend thousands of dollars for curing it. and when it is cut off from my body, it has no value. Similarly, we being part and parcel of God, when we are forgetful or cut off, it cannot be cut off, but still, when we forget God, then we have no value. The same example. When I ask my finger to come here and give me some itching sensation, then the finger is in normal condition. And if the finger cannot give me any service, that is useless. Similarly, we being part and parcel of God, our business is to give service to God. That is our normal condition. And if we do not give service to the Lord, if we keep separately, then we have no value. This point is stressed here, that nāyāṁ deha deha bhājāṁ niloke kastāna kāmān ar hati vīr bhujāṁ jī. Rishabhdev is advising to his sons, my dear sons, this body especially, ayam deha, niloke, in the human society, it is not to be spoiled. Nāyam deha deha bhājāṁ kastāna kāmān. It is not to be spoiled, engaging it uselessly, very hard labor for satisfaction of the senses. Because this kind of business is there, birbhujang. Birbhujang means the stool-eater hogs. The hogs are stool-eater and they are working very hard day and night. And the business is kastana kaman, to satisfy the senses. These two business, where to find out source of income and eat anything without any discrimination, just like the hog has no discrimination. It is prepared to eat even stool. So this kind of life, to work very hard and get foodstuff without any discrimination and then satisfy the senses without any description of sex. The hog will find they have no discrimination of sex, mother, sister or anyone. He'll find these are the natural instructions. So therefore, the example is given here, my dear son, don't live like hogs, toiling whole day and night and eating stool and without any sex discrimination you go on satisfying your senses. This is the first attack to the human civilization, that simply work very, very hard and then satisfy your senses and you take it as civilization. It is not civilization. If we think over these two lines, then we can find out that our modern civilization, it was formerly also the same, but not so extensively at the present moment in this age of Kali. The hog civilization is spread very widely. Therefore, this instruction is very important. Nāyāna deha deha vājāna nilope kastāna kāmāna arhati bīrbhujāna. Human life means very peaceful life without any trouble. That is Vedic civilization. These books written by Vyasadeva, he was writing these books, such exalted knowledge in Haridwar, in a secluded place, very peacefully situated. And that knowledge was taken by the Kshatriyas and they were distributing, as it is said in the Bhagavad Gita, imam rajarsayo vidu. Vedic knowledge was first of all taken up by the Kshatriyas. The Brahmanas, they used to cultivate knowledge and they used to advise the Kshatriyas, rulers. and they took it and they distributed to the general mass of people for the elevation of this spiritual platform. This is civilization. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Chaturvarnam Maya system guna karma vibhagas. This is creation of God, Chaturvarnam, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. This is called Varna. And spiritual cultivation, Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and Sannyas. So our civilization, Vedic civilization, means Varnasamadharma. Following the four principles of Varnas and four principles of Ashrama, the ultimate goal is God realization. That is the human civilization. If there is no God realization, simply working hard day and night for sense gratification, it is accepted as hog civilization, dog civilization. That is stated there. Nāyaṁ deva deva jāṁ yoke rastāna kāvān arhati bhujāṁ yoke. Then, if you give up this kind of civilization, then what is to be done? Tapo dibvam putra kājena saptā suddhe. The next engagement is tapasya, tapo. Tapasya means austerity, penances, voluntarily acceptance of something, some means of activity which may not be very palatable, but still we have to do that. Just like a patient, if he is forbidden by the physician not to take a certain type of foodstuff, it may be pain, just like typhoid fever. The doctor advises, don't take any solid food. But if I am accustomed to take paratha, so in typhoid to take paratha means death. Similarly, we have to follow the Shastric injunction. If we really want to come out this material bondage means this body, our real problem is this body, that we do not know. Nūnaṁ pramatta kurute vikarma jad indriya prītaya aprinoti. This will come, that we have now become mad after sense gratification. Pramatta. Pramatta means prakṣṭa rūpena matta. Matta means mad. And when this affix is there, prefix is there, that pra means prakṣṭa rūpena, sufficiently mad. So, in this material world, we have become sufficiently mad. Not only mad, but sufficiently mad. Nūnaṁ pramatya kurute vikarma. And we are engaged in activities which are forbidden. Forbidden. Just like we are drinking, this is forbidden. We are eating meat, this is forbidden. We are having illicit sex, this is forbidden. We are having gambling, this is forbidden. This is called vikarma. But because we have become mad, whole human civilization is meant for these four things. Illicit sex, meat eating, and intoxication and gambling. So, nūnaṁ pramatta kurute vikarma jat indriya prītaye aprinoti. So, we have become mad and we are engaged in this forbidden work. If we want to get out of these clutches of material bondage, then we must stop these forbidden activities, the activities of a madman. If we go on like that, then we shall have to accept another material body. The problem is that you are suffering threefold miseries, every one of us. Maybe the degree different, but under being intoxicated, we do not take the sufferings as sufferings. That is another madness. But the sufferings are there. That is being pointed out by Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita. Janma mitu jara vyadhi dukkha dosanu darsana. You may be very perfect by arranging your material civilization to enjoy life, but you will not be allowed to leave. That we do not see. There is no insurance. I am making very nice arrangement for my future enjoyment, having bank, good bank balance, nice skyscraper building and other things. But where is the guarantee that you shall live and enjoy? That we do not see. Therefore we are mad, man. If you are arranging something utopian for happiness, and if you understand that I shall die tomorrow, then immediately my enthusiasm will decline. Who is going to take so much trouble? I am going to die tomorrow. So tomorrow not, say 100 years after, you will have to die. You cannot escape this. Janma mitu jara vyadhi dukkha dosanu darsana. So therefore Krishna says that you are very scientifically advanced. There is no doubt about it. But what about your death? That why you shall accept death? You are eternal. Na hannate hannamane sarire. You do not die after the destruction of this body. Nitta shasatayang na hannate hannamane sarire. This information is there. But we are not considering that. We are going on to establish ourselves very tightly in this material world. But Krishna says that you will not be allowed to leave. These things are to be considered. Therefore they have been described as pramatta. Nunam pramatta kurute vikarma jat indriya pritaye apimoti. They are acting sinfully, or they are committing so many sinful activities, and they are becoming entangled for another's body, which is the resultant action of our sinful activities. Therefore Rishabhdev says that nasadu manne, this is not good, that you are wasting your time simply for sense and gratification, and you do not know that you have gotten next life. Dehi nasmin jatha dehi kaumara jobanang jara tatha dehantara prapti dhiyastatva namuhiyati. You are living entity, you are not this flesh and bones. You are spirit soul. And you are within this body. You are now entrapped with this material body. And so long you will act irresponsibly, you will get another material, tatha dehantara prapti. You will get another body. And that body is not guaranteed. There are 8,400,000 different forms of body. Sarvajonishu kaunteya. Although the spirit soul is there, but this particular type of body, the hog's body or the man's body or the demigod's body, there are so many. Jalajana vulakkhani sthavara lokavinsati. There are 900,000 forms of body within the water. Sthavara lokavinsati, and there are trees, plants, 2,000,000 forms of body. So we have already gone through all this body, and we have got this human form of body after many, many millions of years by evolutionary process. Therefore, Rishabhdev says, ayana deha, this body, don't think it is ordinarily received. Nayana deha devahadanga, nilok, in the human society. You should not waste it like the hogs and dogs, simply for sense gratification. This is the Bhagavad instruction. You should soberly use it. So, how soberly used? That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Jānti deva vrata devān pitrīn jānti pitrīn vrata bhūtejā jānti bhūtāni madjājino ki jānti mā. You can utilize this body properly for a higher standard of life. You can go to the higher planetary system. The higher planetary system begins from the sun. That is another subject matter. But so far you get information from Srimad Bhagavatam, there sun, then moon, according to Bhagavatam. And I think we are talking about this thing, that whether the moon is the first planet or the sun is the first planet. So far we understand from Vedic literature, the moon is the second planet, the sun is the first planet. If we consider like that, then moon is beyond the sun planet. Their estimation is there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. 1,600,000 miles above the sun, the moon is situated. Now, if we take consideration of the sun planet situated 93 million miles from Earth, then add 1,600,000 miles again, it comes to 15 million. 95 million miles away from the earthly planet. And how you can reach there in 4 days? 95 million miles away. If we apply our common sense, then it appears they have never gone to the moon planet. It is all bogus propaganda. It is not possible. So, Shastra Chakshusha, our knowledge should be through the Shastra. That is practical. And our process of knowledge is this. We get knowledge from Shastra, like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Vedic knowledge. We do not claim to be very big scientists. That is not possible. But we get knowledge from the best scientific man, or person, like personality of Godhead, Krishna, Vyasdev, Narada, Asita, Devala, later on the Acharyas, Ramanucharya, Madhvacharya, Shankaracharya, Chaitanya. Our process of knowledge is not any speculation. It may be perhaps, no, we don't accept this knowledge. It may be perhaps, these are all foolishness. That means one who has no perfect knowledge, he will say, it may be, perhaps. One who has definite knowledge, why he will say, it may be. It must be. That is knowledge. Just like we get knowledge from the Shastra, Jalajanavalakhana. There are 900 species or forms of life in the water. So we have not gone into the water. But we get from the authorities, Padma Purana, and we accept it. So our process of knowledge, you may say that you have not practically experimented, but what you have experimented? You also hear from others. You believe that they have gone to moon planet. You have not gone. You have heard from somebody in the newspaper. That's all. That is your authority. So if you can believe in the newspaper, then I cannot believe in the Shastras. So it is a different source of knowledge, but one text, one source, another text, another source. Our source of knowledge is Krishna or Krishna's disciples. That is our. Evam parampara praptam imam rajab sayovit. This is the source of knowledge. Avarahopantha. Knowledge coming from higher authorities. Just like this of that is giving knowledge to his sons. That is natural. Sons take advice from the father. That is the beginning of knowledge. If a little child asks the father, my dear father, what is this machine? The father says, my dear child, this is called microphone. So when the child says, after hearing from the father, that it is microphone, that is perfect knowledge. The child may be an innocent child, he does not know, he is not a scientist. But when, after hearing from the authority father, if he says it is microphone, that statement is correct. There is no mistake. Similarly, we may be fools and rascals. That's all right. But when we receive knowledge from Krishna, who says, asmin dehe, dehin asmin, jatko marajuvana, tatha dehantara prap. When Krishna says that within this body there is the living soul, and the living soul is transmigrating. Tathā dehāntara prāpti. As we are getting different bodies in this life also, from childhood to boyhood, from boyhood to old body. Then what is after old body? Tathadehantara-prati. You get another body. But we do not know what kind of body we are getting. Where is that science? Where is that education? That there is dehantara-prati, there is transmigration of the soul, and there are so many different types of body. Suppose at this, in this body I am very comfortably situated, I am a very big man, or very great minister, politician, everything is all right. But in the next life, if I am going to get the body of a dog, who can check it? Nature's law will go on. At that time, as minister or big man, if you dictate that give me a body like this, oh, that will not be hard. You'll get a type of body according to your karma. Karmala-adaiva-netrena jantar-deho-vapatti. According to your karma, you'll get a type of body. This is nature's law. Prakita-kriyamanani-gunai-karmani-sarva. You are completely under the grip of nature's law. We cannot change it. If you challenge that there is no death, no, death will come. That is nature's law. And if you want to stop death, then that is another process. That is described here. Kapo dibbang putra jena sattang suddhe. You have to accept this process of austerity by which he'll purify your existence. Then he'll get deathless life, itana. Jadgatyana nivartanti tadhamam paramam mama. Tatta dehang punarjanma naiti mamiti kohantiya. This is the science. This Bhagavata literature, this Vedic literature is giving you information how you can revive your original eternal life. Nitya-sāsatayaṁ-nahannati-hannavāni-sarīya. That is the business of human life, not to become mad like hogs and dogs and simply work very hard, wear his stool and eat it and get some strength and then enjoy senses. This is not life. This is not civilization. So Rishabhdev's instruction is tapo dibbanga putra gadina sattanga suddhe. Why it is necessary to purify my existence? Suddhe jasmat brahma sukham tu arantam. You are seeking after happiness, but your happiness is being checked. You have made very good arrangement for enjoying life, happiness, but it is being checked. You have to die. You make all nice arrangement, but you have to die. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Mittu sarva harascaham. Aham, Krishna says, that those persons who do not want me, or persons who do not like to understand God, they will see God, me, when? At the time of death. As Hiranyakashipu saw. He challenged always God. His son was devotee, and that was a misunderstanding between the father and the son. Father says that God is enemy, Vishnu is my enemy. You do not take the name of Vishnu, and the child, boy, will take that is the cause of enmity. So, at the end, he saw Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu saw Nrisimhadeva. Immediately finished everything. So that is the case of everyone, that one has to meet death. And at the time of death, whatever arrangement he has made for so-called happiness will be taken up. Mrittu sarva harastha. Then he will be offered another body. It may be a human body, or it may be a dog's body or hawk's body, and we have to accept it. Prakita-kriya-manani gunai-karmani sarvasa. Ahankara-vimura-atma-kartaham iti mannate. Karanam guna-sangasya. Sadasat-janma-junishu. The laws of nature is working, and as it is infecting a particular type of the more sumerial nature, he is preparing his next body. karanam gunasanga asya sadasat janmajoni. So in the human form of life, if you do not purify your existence, if you do not realize God, if you do not understand what is my relationship with God, then we are simply wasting time living like cats and dogs. These things should be stopped, and our Krishna consciousness movement is meant for stopping this rascal civilization and giving him life. Thank you very much.
It's a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, text number 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 22, 1975, in Durban, South Africa.
Mahasivana dharmahu jimukti stamadvaram jushitam sangisangam mahantasti samachitta prasanta vimannabhasru hidasadho ji. In continuation of the last bhag I recited in day before yesterday, the second bhag, the suggesting how one can be liberated from these material bondage. In the first verse, it was suggested that this human form of life is not meant for wasting uselessly like the animals, dogs and hogs. It should be properly utilized. The suggestion was tapasya. Tapasya means austerity, voluntarily accepting some inconvenience. This is called tapasya. Tapa, one meaning is disturbance. Suppose I am practiced to some heavily. If I advise to give it up, it becomes little troublesome. For example, if I am habituated to smoke and somebody or higher authorities say, don't smoke. To give up smoking is little difficult, those who are habituated to smoke. Similarly, but according to the doctor's advice, if somebody has to give up smoking, he has to. Otherwise, his disease may not be cured. Similarly, our this present position, tapo dibbang putra kajena suddhita satya, we are constantly repeatedly changing body, transmigration of the soul, tatha dehantara prati, that means we are accepting death. Death means change of the, final change of the body. When this body is no more useful to continue, then by nature, another body is offered. At the time of death, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, jang-jang bapi smaran loki tadattanti kalevaram chadatadabhavabhavit. We create a mental situation. We have got two kinds of bodies, subtle body and gross body. This gross body is made of five gross material elements. Earth, water, fire, air, ether. And the subtle body He is made of mind, intelligence and ego. When we sleep, the gross body does not work, but the subtle body works. We dream therefore. At the time of death, this gross body is finished. But the subtle body, mind, intelligence and ego will carry me to another gross body. It will enter into the womb of another mother and she will create another similar body like the mother, and when it is complete, then it will come out. So the spirit soul in this way bound up by the material gross body and subtle body. This is our disease. This is material existence means we are suffering from this disease. So in the first verse it was suggested by Rishabha to his sons, my dear sons, tapo putraka, tapo dibbhama putraka, jina suddheta satya, jasmad brahma saukham anantam. Our position is, as I explained the other day, we are part and parcel of God. God's existence is Satchitananda Vigraha, eternal, blissful knowledge. So we are part and parcel. Our knowledge, our blissfulness, our eternity may be very small, but we possess the same quality. Anandamaya Abhyasa. In the Vedanta Sutra, it is said, the spirit soul, or God, God is the Supreme Spirit, and we are minute. He is Vibhu, unlimited. We are Anu, very small, molecular, or atomic. So, quality is the same. So our seeking after eternity, seeking after full knowledge and to remain blissful, that is our nature, because we are part and parcel of God. But on account of being covered by these material elements, earth, water, air, fire, ether, mind, intelligence and ego, we are suffering this disease, janma mrityu jara vyadhi. Janma means birth and mrityu means death. As soon as we take birth, it means we must be prepared for death. I am increasing my age means decreasing my age, not increasing. When a child is born, if some friends ask when this child is born, now 1 week before, that means the child has already died 1 week. From his duration of life, make 1 week minus. So we are dying every moment. Mrityu, death is sure as death. So, but we are not meant for death, neither we are meant for birth. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Na jayate naam liyate va. The spirit soul is never born, neither he dies. Nitta sasatoyam na hannate hannavani sariri. The spirit soul, nitta, eternal, sasa, inexhaustible. Na hannate, clearly says, na hannate hannavani sariri. So this death is artificial. Therefore we do not like to die. We do not like to be unhappy. We do not like to be without any knowledge. This is our nature. But because this nature is hampered on material condition. Therefore, the business of the human being is to cure this disease, birth, death, old age and disease. This is the mission of life. Not to waste time, not to waste our life, duration of life, just simply jumping like dog and horse. That is not human life. Therefore you have to undergo tapasya. We should not indulge whimsically to anything. That is not human life. Therefore human life, there is need of education. There is need of regularities. There is need of following the instruction of the authorities. That is in human life. Law is meant for the human life, not for the cats and dogs. Therefore, Rishabhdev suggested that you practice austerity. Austerity means, I have already explained, I do not like to do anything, but for curing this material disease, I have to do that. This is called austerity. The same example. I have habituated to smoke. I don't like if somebody says, don't smoke. It is difficult for me. But I have to do it if you want to cure my disease. This is called austerity. So, according to Vedic system, we should be sinless. Unless we become sinless, there is no possibility of understanding God. That is not possible. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Jesham tu antagatam papam jananam punyakarmanam te dandamaha nimukta bhajante imam dhirabhrata. A person who has completely finished the reaction of his sinful life. Jesham tu antagatam papam jananam punyakarmanam. So if we be engaged in punyakarma, pious activities, then there is no chance of acting impiously. So punya karma, jagadana tapakriya, these are the activities of piety. Jagva, performing sacrifice. There are different types of sacrifices mentioned, but in this age it is difficult. Therefore, in this age, the easiest sacrifice is chanting this Hare Krishna mantra. Jaggai sankirtanai prayai jajanti hi sumedhas. This, performing this jagga, sankirtan jagga, you have to simply agree, otherwise you have no loss, simply you have gain. Chant Hare Krishna, we are not asking anybody to give us some peace, some dollars, then you chant. No, it is free. You can chant if you like. This is yoga. This is the yoga of this age. Anyone can join. It doesn't matter that this class of men will join. No, anyone. Poor, rich, white, black, illiterate, learned, everyone. Yagvai Sankirtan means Bhavi Militva. Many people assemble together when glorify the Lord, that is called Sankirtan. So this Hare Krishna Mahamantra means we are preaching all over the world. There is no difficulty. Everyone is joining. Everyone is chanting. So it is not very difficult task, any kind. This is Yagva. And then Dana. Dana means charity. So, whatever you earn, at least some percentage of your money should be given in charity. The best charity is to give for spreading this Krishna consciousness movement, God consciousness. Krishna says, dadasita kurushyata madarpanam. If you want to give in charity something, please give me. Krishna says, God says. So, Jagaddana tapa, again tapa, austerity. Jagaddana tapa kriya, pavanani manisina. We should not give up this practice. Performing jagga, giving in charity, and practicing tapasya. This is essential for the human being. This should be practiced as far as possible. So, this is called pious activities. So, one should be engaged in pious activities, then there will be no chance of committing sinful activities. In this way, when you are mature, jeshaṁ tu antagatam pāpa, no more sinful life, pure life. Jeshaṁ tu antagatam pāpa, janānāṁ punya karmānāṁ. Always practicing pious activities. Te dandamaha nirmukta. Such person, without any doubt, without any duality, can be engaged in the service of the Lord. Such person. Therefore, Rishabhde says, Tapo devvanga putraka. Putraka, my dear boys, my dear sons, don't waste your time dying hogs and dogs. Just practice tapasya. Tapo dibbam. Dibbam, dibbam means, but divine purpose. Not for manufacturing some weapon for killing thousands of men at a time. This requires also tapasya. Very great attention, labor and perseverance, everything required. That is called tapasya. But not that kind of tapasya for the inauspicious position of the human society. No, tapodhibbam, for divine understanding. So the benefit will be jena suddheta satta. Then our existence, the position, existence and that position will be purified. And what will be the result if it is purified? Jena brahma sokham ananta. We are seeking after eternal life, we are seeking after happiness, and we are seeking after full knowledge. That will be attained. So, tapo dibbanga putraka jena suddhita satta jasma brahma sokham ananta. That is success of life. Now, in the next verse, how we can practice tapasya. That is recommended here. Mahasevam. Mahasevam dharam ahur vimukti. Mahat, great soul. Mahat means great soul. Who is great soul? Mahatmanastumam prartha devi prakriti maastrita. Great soul means who has taken shelter of the spiritual nature. He is great soul. There are two natures, spiritual nature and material nature. We can understand material nature, this body, and spiritual nature, the soul. And there are two things within our this existence, matter and spirit. Similarly, there are two energies of God. One energy is called material energy, and the other is called spiritual energy. God is appreciated. We can understand God, there is God, by the presence of His energy. Just like we can understand there is sun in the presence of the sunlight. Light is the energy of the sun. In the morning, as soon as you see through your door, window, that there is now light. You can understand there is sunrise. So we can understand the existence of God by the presence of His energy. By the presence of His energy. Just like sun is appreciated by the presence of heat and light. Similarly, whatever we see in this world, there are two energies working. material energy and spiritual energy. We can understand there is God. Otherwise, where from this energy is coming? As soon as we get heat and light, we understand there is the sun. Similarly, sarvidam akilam jagat. Ekostani thitasagne jyotsna vistarina jatha parasa brahmana shakti sarvidam akilam jagat. What is this world? This world is distribution of the two energies of God, the material energy and the spiritual energy. So mahat means one who has taken shelter of the spiritual energy. He is called mahat. Great soul. So far the material energy is concerned, then generally all living entities who are in this material world, they have taken the shelter of the material energy, 8,400,000 forms of body. But the mahat means one who has taken the shelter of the spiritual energy. So mahasyama, we have to approach such person who has taken the shelter of the spiritual energy of God. Mahasyamam daram ahur vimukti. If you want liberation from this bondage, birth, death, old age and disease and so many other things, then you have to execute tapasya under the direction of a great soul. Mahasyama daram ahur vimukti. If you want liberation, and tamadvaram, tamadvaram josita anisangisanga. Josita, josita means, josit means omen. So this material energy is, every energy is omen. The spiritual energy also omen. Material energy is omen. The material energy is tamo, darkness. And the other energy is the light. Therefore, Vedic injunction is tamasima jyotirgama. Don't remain under these, the darkness material energy. In the Chandi, those who have read Chandi, jadevi sarvabhutana nidra rupena samasthita. The material energy's business is to keep us in slumber without any pure knowledge. This is material energy. So if we keep ourselves within the material energy, that is, that will lead us more and more in the darkest region of hellish condition of life. Samadharam. Samadharam josita visandisham. Those who are too much materially affected, to associate with such person means you remain within the material energy. And if you associate with persons who are great souls, who are taking the shelter of spiritual energy, the path of liberation will be open. This is the purpose. Mahasyamanadharam ahu vimukti samadharam jyositam sangisangam. Mahantaste samajitya. And how I can understand who is mahat or great soul. That description is given. Mahantaste samasitya, equilibrium. They are kind to everyone. There is no discrimination. Samasitya, that means spiritual realization. To see everyone on equal level. Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmani gavi hastini. Sunite cha sapake cha pandita samadarsha. In another place it is said, brahma bhuta prasannatma nasotati natankati sama sarveshu bhuteshu. This is samachit. Equally disposed to everyone. Not that he is American, so I shall be kind to him. Or he is Indian, I shall be kind to him. He is black, I shall be kind to him. He, no, everyone. Pandita, Samadarsha, Samuchitta, this is the qualification of grace. There is no distinction. He is such and such person, therefore I have no business with him. No, the preaching. Krishna is preaching to everyone. Christ is preaching to everyone. They are called Mahanta. Mahanta means great soul. So, here it is said, Mahantaste Samuchitta Prasanta, always very peaceful, Pakrishta Rupena Santa. There is no disturbance, because he knows himself. He is not disturbed by any material condition. Ahi Dukhi Apratihata, spiritual advancement of life is never hindered by any material condition. It is not that I am under such and such condition, I cannot make any advancement in spiritual life. No. Spiritual advancement is never checked by material condition. Therefore we say, Prasanta, Vimannava. He is never angry. Never angry. Vimannava, Suhido, Su, in a well wisher for everyone. That is the vision of Mahāprabhu. He is seeing that without God consciousness, without his relationship with God, he is suffering. Śrīra, sādhava, sādhava, sādhu. The saman substance, sādhu means saintly person. So who is saintly person? Titiksava kārunika śrīra sarva-bhūtāna. Sādhu means, saintly person means titiksava, tolerant. Tolerant. Without being disturbed. Now, in the Western countries, Lord Jesus Christ, the tolerant, is being crucified, still he is praying to God, please accept him. Now, of course, his position is different. So one should try to become sadhu. Sadhu. Titiksava karunika sridhat sarva-bhutana. So, the saman substance of sadhu means, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, mancha bhavishna upite sutura-chara bhajate mamananabha sadhu riva saman. If one is staunchly adhered to the service of the Lord, he is called sadhu, saintly person, sadhu. Mahantaste samachitta prasanta vimannava svira sadhava ji. These are the qualifications of Mahatma, great soul. So we have to find out, the basic injunction is try to find out such person that you have to take. Tadvidhi panipatena paripasnena sevaya. You find out such person and associate with him. Try to serve him. Panipatena, by fully surrender. Tadvidhi panipatena paripasnena sevaya. Upadakshanti tadgyanam. Gyanina. So, we have to approach such person. As it is described here. Mahasiva. I have to give my service to the great soul. And these are the symptoms of great soul. So, as we are finding out so many things for our satisfaction, so our real business is how to get out of this material disease. And to get out of this material disease, the prescription is given here, mahaseva. Just try to serve a great soul. And who is a great soul? That is described here. Mahantaste samachitta prasanta vimannava suhida sadhava je. Then, the next verse it is said, this sadhu, this mahatma, generally those who are in the renounced order of life. There are four grades of life. Brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha and sannyasi. The description already given, it is meant for mendicants who have nothing to do with material affairs or household life, renounce order, sannyasa, that is applicable to them. But another Mahatma also is recommended here. Jiva maise kritasauhidartha janesu deham bhravatikesu grihesu jayatma ja ratimaksu na priti jukta javat athyasya loke. Another, that grihastha, householder, it is not that simply sannyasi renounced order. Those have renounced this material connection, they can become great soul. Not necessarily. Even those who are in family life, living with wife, children, friends, they can also become great soul. They can become great soul. So how they can become great soul? Jeva maise krita sauhidartha. They are such grihastha householder. It's not exactly meant for how to get money, how to get money. No. Their aim is how to get friendship of the Lord. That is their aim. It doesn't matter. He lives with wife and children. That doesn't matter. But what is the aim of his life? The aim of his life mai ise kritasau hidartha. This instruction is given by Rishabdev, he is incarnation of God. Therefore he said, one who is seeking the friendship of being, or God, Krita-sau-hidartha. His only business is how to keep friendship with Krishna, just like Arjuna. Arjuna is a householder, and he is a Kshatriya, royal family, and he was a warrior. He knew how to fight. But his friendship with Krishna was very, very intense. Krita-sau-hidartha. Therefore, Krishna instructed Arjuna. Arjuna, I am instructing this mystery of Bhagavad Gita unto you. Arjuna might have said that, why you are giving me instruction? I am neither sannyasi nor a very learned scholar in Vedanta, or I am grihastha, householder, a politician, and royal family. So why you have selected me? Na bhaktosi. Because you are my devotee. This is what. Bhaktosi. Grihastha. Not only ordinary friend, very dear friend. So if you become dear friend, like Arjuna, of Krishna, God, then in whatever position you remain, you are Mahatma, great soul. That is it. It is not that. In the Kali Yuga, in this age, it is very difficult to accept renounced order of life. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommended that you remain in your position. It doesn't matter. But become a Mahatma, great soul. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sāne sthita śrutigatāna tanuvāna manobhi prāyasa jita jita. The process is how to become Mahatma. That process is recommended by Chaitanya Mahāprabhu. Not it is his manufactured process, but it is recommended in the Vedic Shastra. What is that? Jñāne prayāsam udapāsa namanta eva. The process is, don't try to speculate on God. Give up this process, this bad habit. You cannot speculate. No. Jnana prayasa. This is called jnana. Jnana means knowledge. Acquire knowledge. Everyone is trying to, nobody is interested now to understand what is God. But there are some. But they are trying to understand God by mental speculation. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this practice should be given up. Speculation. Jnana prayasam udapa namantaya. Just become submissive. Namantaya. Don't think that I am very learned scholar. I can manufacture my own way how to find out God, or I am God, and so on and so on. These practice will be yuna. Just become humble and meek. Jnani prayasam udupasa namavuta eva. Then, what shall I do? Becoming humble and meek. Sarvakharitana bhavadiyo vartha. You try to understand about God from a God-realized person. That will help. Sthanesthita. There is no need of changing your position. You remain wherever you are. Sutikratana tanuvagamanovhi. Just lend your this oral reception and try to hear about God from the self-realized person, from Mahatma. Then one day it will become so that although God is unconquerable, you will conquer Him. Prayana ajita jitapasi, you will conquer. God, you cannot conquer God. But God agrees to be conquered by His devote. This is the indirect meaning, to become devote. This is the way. And what is the devotional way? Savanam kirtanam Vishnu. Just try to hear about Vishnu, the Supreme Lord. Savanam, the first years, that you have kindly come here. You are trying to hear. This is very good. This is the beginning of us. Then kirtanam, savanam kirtanam. Whatever you hear, you discuss among yourself. That is called kirtanam. Savanam kirtanam Vishnu smaranam. Remember about the topics of God. Savanam kirtanam Vishnu smaranam padasivanam archanam bandhanam. There are 9 methods. Archanam, temple worship. So, any one of these methods will help you. If you take the 9 methods, that is very good. If not, take 8. If not, take 7. If not, take 6. Take 5, 4, 3, 2, take at least one. That one is very easy, Sravanam. We are opening several centers of Krishna Consciousness Movement. Not only we are renting, there are many other centers also to hear about God. That is very essential. Sravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Pradasa. So, this process can be practiced even at home. There is no necessity that you have to change your place, you have to give up your business, you have to give up your occupation, or you have to give up your family relationship. No. You remain in here. But practice this, sarvanam. Just as you are hearing here in this hall, you can do it at home. These books are there. I am speaking from the book. You can speak also from the book. And sit down amongst your family members and chant Hare Krishna. So, the aim should be how to become friend of God. It doesn't matter whether you remain at home or out of home. Narottam Das Thakur said, Griheva bonete thako hago unango bole da. Either you remain at home or outside home. You chant Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhara, Sri Bhasani, Gaur Bhakti. This is the person, very simple person, and Hare Krishna. And if you want, of course knowledge will come automatically. If your heart is purified by this Samanam Kautanam method, Chaita Dharpanam Anjanam, then the heart will be purified. And God is situated within your heart. Then, as soon as your heart is purified, you will be able to see God within yourself, within your heart. That is called meditation. You see God within yourself and see it constantly, here is God, here is Krishna. That is meditation. So, premanyana surita bhakti bilochanena Santa sadaiva ridayesu vilokayanti. Santa, saintly person, Mahatma, they develop by hearing about God constantly. They develop love of God. That is the aim of life. That is the real purpose of human life. Prima Pumartha Maha. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recommended that what is the actual benefit of this human form of life? To develop our dormant love for God. That is what. Not to accumulate money. Nothing will go with us. Everything will remain. The bank balance will remain in the bank and we have to go. And there will be fight among the claimants. So that will be created. But then nothing will go with you. Simply, your consciousness, Krishna consciousness, will help you. At the time of death, if you remember, Krishna, janga janga vapi smaran loki, tajantanti kalevaram. Somewhere or other, if you remember at the time of death, Krishna, then your life is successful. So it doesn't matter whether you remain outside home or inside home, what is your occupation, but do not forget your real business. This is the Krishna consciousness moment. So jiva maise kritasau hidartha janesu deham bharvathakesu grihesu jayatma jarati mastu na priti yukta. The symptom of a Mahatma, great soul, is described here. What is that? That griham bharvathakesu. Those who are simply planning how to keep this body comfortable. That is the material one. Everyone is busy. How to keep this body very comfortable. Although it is not possible. There are so many disturbances, so many miserable conditions, that there is no possibility of keeping this body in comfortable position. That is not. That is a fact. But still we are trying. They are caught. Deham bharobhattikesu. Just to make gorgeous arrangement for keeping this body very comfortable. They are called deham bharobhattikesu. They are simply busy. How to keep this body comfortable? To such person, janesu deham bharobhattikesu and grihesu, although he is at home, then jaya means wife. Jaya atmaja, the children. And rati, money. These things are required. Household. Wife required, children required, money required, place required. So, no priti yukta. His business is not how to increase money, how to please the, relatives, how to talk with the persons interested in keeping this body. No priti yukta. He is not interested with them. Priti yukta, javadarthastho loke, simply just be engaged with them as far as your duty. It does not mean that I am not attached to my wife, therefore I shall forget my duties to wife and children. It doesn't mean. Javadarthastho loke, as it is my duty, I must execute. But my main business is how to secure friendship with Krishna. Such kind of grihastha is Mahatma. So there are two kinds of Mahatma. One is renounce order. They are preaching all over the world for the benefit of the society. And the grihastha, he may not be preaching, he can preach. Amongst his relatives, members, children, he can also preach. Friends. So preaching cannot be stopped. You can do small scale or big scale. The benefit will be savanamukhi kana. Just like we are preaching, we are hearing also. And you are chanting. So this chanting and hearing process should be increased. One should try to become sinless and try to make friendship with God. Then our life will be successful. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.